medical services on the island are provided by the administration and do not come under the authority of the Australian Postal Commission. There is no internal postal delivery service except private mailboxes available on rent. Mail is carried to and from the island by air and sea. The administration at government offices provides territory residents and visitors with assistance on citizenship, immigration and travel document matters. The Bank of New South Wales and the United Credit Union Society Limited provides banking facilities to island residents. Cash crops on Christmas Island, but a number of people raise poultry and produce green leaf vegetables and fruits, and also fishing for local consumption on a small scale. There are small restaurants in most parts of the residential areas and at Flying Fish Cove, serving Chinese and Malay fruits. Harbour facilities are at Flying Fish Cove. It is often a port of call for private yachts from all over the world cruising the Indian Ocean. In 1886, a survey vessel, the Flying Fish, made a landing on this cove, later known as Flying Fish Cove. Another visit by HMS Algeria in 1887 made an extensive collection of flora and fauna, and in 1888, Christmas Island was annexed by Britain. In the same year, Mr. George Cronis Ross of the Cocos Killing Islands established the first permanent settlement at Flying Fish Cove. From the phosphate and supply ships, which are regular callers, the only visitors by sea are occasional passengers' ships diverted from the normal route between Fremantle, Eastern Australia and Singapore to give tourists a glimpse of the island as the steam passed, and yachtsmen on round-the-world voyages. ¶¶ Crop of rock, fashioned from all kinds of scrap, embedded in sculptured cement, was fashioned by one of the men once working at this site. This monument seems to reveal a pastime sinister story. This site is known as Waterfall, a tiny bay on the eastern side of the island. A small freshwater stream falls into the sea from over a cliff. Waterfall has been a principal source for fresh water and has a pumping station. Major roads in the island and minor roads in all developed areas. Most of the tracks into the island's forest are suitable only for four-wheel drive vehicles. Motor vehicles registrations at 30th of June 1980 totaled 1,247. Established in recent years to provide young native jungle trees for planting in phosphate mined our areas. It is hoped that such planting will help speed revegetation of the ugly scars left by mining and provide habitat for Christmas Island's unique wildlife. About 7,000 young trees are produced each year. fresh water needs of both depopulation and the phosphate industry are supplied by a number of springs and underground streams. The porous nature of the ground prevents any natural surface accumulation of rainwater. In spite of that, there are several good springs and underground streams. Water is pumped from Ross Hill Gardens, Jetta Cave, Janot Well, Waterfall Beach, and a place here known as Grand's Well. Weekend for a picnic, and Lily Beach is no exception, a very small beach on Christmas Island's east coast. Despite its small size and exposure to prevailing southeast trade winds and swells, Lily Beach is a very important spot for recreation.